the north shore of the Allegheny River. We're inside beautiful PNC Park in Pittsburgh. Coming up, we've got a good matchup in store between the Chicago White Sox and the Oakland A's.
And now, your 2021.
It's baseball on the show,
Oakland,
and it's coming up next.
Athletic.
And that'll bring up the shortstop, Tim Anderson. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. Two and one count to the Pale Host leadoff hitter.
Wow, third pitch of the game. That looked like a pretty good pitch. If that's called a ball, it could be a rough night for the pitchers tonight.
3-1 to him now. A little chilly, but not unbearable tonight. 55 degrees here at first pitch. Full count, 3-2. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Marte's after it, but he can't make the play as it finds the outfield grass.
Batting second, the center fielder, Luis Robert.
Stepping in now, Luis Robert. Outside, 2-1. Anderson on at first, nobody out. A little early, and now it's even at 2-2. Has a look, now the pitch. And this is popped foul, but perhaps playable behind first. Olsen is over, and he puts it away for the first down. Striding in is Jose Abreu. His career numbers in this matchup, he has a 3-for-12 line. Now a throw over to first. And he'll get dirty, but he's back in safely. The 2-2. And this one's in the dirt, but it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. Working for the punch out and the offering. And he misses with that one for ball four. So that'll put runners on first and second now with one away.
A
1-1 is a changeup that's looked at for a ball.
Has to be a challenge pitch coming up here. He probably doesn't want to flirt with loading the bases.
Now the double steal is on here. Count even at 2-2. First and second now, one man out. Fouled away. Timing just to tick off there as this one's fouled off to the right. The 2-2 one more time. Towards second. To second for one. On to first, but not in time as he beats it out. So now here is Yoan Moncada looking to put them ahead early with this at bat. Already 24 pitches to this point in the inning. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. The 2-2. Hit hard up the middle. Oh, look at the sliding stuff. Hey now. And that'll bring up Josh Harrison. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. It's 2-1 to the A's leadoff batter. Lifetime against this particular arm. He has an even 10 hits in 31 tries. Two of those hits were for home runs. Two balls and two strikes now. Full count now, 3-2.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
And he takes ball four. So the leadoff man is on here in the home half of the first in a scoreless ball game.
Mark.
The 1-1. is swung on and missed for strike number
two.
Looked like he was going to wait him out, see if he was going to come over the heart of the plate. Well, newsflash, he is, and this hitter is going to adjust his batting gloves, and he better be ready in the box.
Robert will settle under it to make the play for the first down as the runner will have to head back to first. Next to hit, Matt Olson.
The first
chance for him here with a runner at first and one gone.
Olson.
The 1-2. This is hit the other way out toward left field. Waiting on it is Jimenez, and he makes the catch for the second out. Up next, Mark Canna. Lifetime versus this pitcher. Seven hits in 15 at-bats.
Canna.
The 1-1 home. Harrison leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. Looked like the fastball got away from him there. It's ball two.
I know he missed with a fastball right there, but this guy's arsenal. You can't figure out what he's trying to do. He's got a lot of different directions he could go in right here.
Lynn comes set. Here he comes on 2-2. Swing and a miss, and that's out number three. New inning set to get underway, and that'll bring in the veteran catcher, Yasmani Grandal. Two pitches fouled away. Into the windup and the pitch. And the sinking fastball called strike three, and that's out number one. Up next for Chicago, Gavin Sheets. No score here as we play inning number two. And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. Fouled off. The 2-2 one more time. And another foul ball. The 2-2 one more time. Is a call. Third strike down in the zone. Andrew Vaughn the next to bat. He'll attempt to put the ball in play for a change here with the first two guys going down on strikes to start the inning. And this ball runs away for ball two. 2-1.
Wow, that's 40 pitches for him already. This doesn't have the makings of a...
Hits it high and deep out to center field. Marte going back. And that one is gone! Into the box now, Cesar Hernandez. It's 1-2. Just hung in there on that one. White Sox are out to an early 1-0 lead as we play the second.
Whoa, ball two. Down.
Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. Ready with another 2-2. On the eighth pitch of the at-bat is the one that finally does it as he wears him down and the inning is over. Last half of the second set to go and standing in the outfielder, Seth Brown. The 1-1 home.
Two balls, one strike, the count.
On the ground and right at the shifted infielder. Fielded cleanly, and there's one away. At the plate now is Matt Chapman. Lifetime in this matchup. Just a 2-for-14 line, so advantage pitcher here. He's gone down on strikes 8 times as well.
I got to count 1-2.
Looked like that one tied him up a bit, a swing and a miss. And it's fouled away. There's a fastball well off the plate for a ball. Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number two. Chris Davis next to bat. Try to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Robert able to track it down for the third out. So it's back to the top of the order now, and up next it'll be Tim Anderson. Count full, three balls and two strikes. Hammered the other way to deep right field. A ball that's carrying. On the warning track, he makes the catch. One out here in the Shy Sox third. And into bat next is Luis Robert. Now the 1-1 pitch. Hit out towards second. Scooped up, and there are two away now. So here's the slugging first baseman Jose Abreu now. Worked a walk in his first plate appearance. Now another 2-2. Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. Leading off the inning, it'll be Tony Kemp as they'll look to spark the offense and even things up. 1-1.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence. He's got great body language on the mound. He's got fastball command and a nice early feel for his off-speed stuff.
Even at two balls and two strikes, here's the pitch. Fastball swung on and missed for the first out. Next up is Sean Murphy. Lifetime against this pitcher. He's 0 for 5. Now the 1-1 pitch. A's still looking for that elusive first hit of the ball game. And there's the first hit for the A's. To the plate now, Josh Harrison. Down low, two balls and a strike.
Got it.
And there he goes towards second. All even now, 2-2. Has a look, now the pitch. And he lays off, so it's full now, 3-2.
Not a bad time right here to put that runner in motion. 3-2 count. You send the runner, and if it's a bad pitch, it's ball four.
Hernandez at second. Throw back to Abreu. They get them both, and the side is retired. All set for the start of the fourth. And up next, the exciting Eloy Jimenez. The 2-1 home. Now here's a comebacker back to the mound. And he'll flip on the first to record the out. So here is Yoan Moncada. Here now the 2-2. Swing and a liner. A leap, but he can't bring it down. Base hit. Yasmani Grandal looked like the cut fastball there, and he got him to swing through it for the second out.
the bat.
To the plate now is the designated hitter, Gavin Sheets. He went down looking in his last trip to the plate.
You know, Matty, tough to go down looking right there, especially in a long at bat. I kind of tip my hat to the fact that he...
And the throw is in time to get him to retire the side. Now at the plate is Starling Marte. Flew out in his only at-bat so far. High in the air down the right field line. But this is just going to wind up being a foul ball. Now the 3-2 pitch. And that misses for ball four. It's a leadoff walk that starts the bottom of the fourth. And that'll bring up Matt Olson. Flied out in his first at-bat, so making 0-for-1 so far.
Almost, Matty. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
Pitch outside the throw. And it's far too late as he steals second with ease. Skied into straightaway right. And that's taken. Will he try from second? So stepping in is Mark Canna trying to bring in the tying run from third here. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Popped him up. Abreu has a play. And that's the second out of the inning. Striding in is Seth Brown. Potential time run for him at third base. A 1-1 pitch. Swung on and hit deep to left center. This one has a chance. And he will crash into the wall, but hold on to it there for the final out of the inning. Top of the fifth, and that'll bring forth the rookie outfielder Andrew Vaughn. The 1-2. Hit in the air down the left field line. But this is just going to wind up being a foul ball.
Hey, having a B right here, I know it's frustrating the heck out of the pitcher. You keep fouling these pitchers off, maybe one misses over the heart of the plate.
Here now the 2-2. And here's a ball hit in the air. Right fielder giving chase. He makes the catch. A great effort to get there and record the first out of the inning. Stepping in once again is Cesar Hernandez. He's 0-for-1 thus far. Now the pitch. One run on three hits and no errors so far for the White Sox. And it's 3-2 now to the number 9 hitter.
These last two guys are making him work quite a bit out there. Both have been long at bats, and all in all, he's had to make 13 throws just to them so far.
Here comes the payoff pitch. Lifted down the line and left. But this is just going to wind up being a foul ball. Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. And he finally wins as this is swung on and missed for the second out. And the next to bat will be Tim Anderson. 1-for-2 with a base hit back in the first inning of play. Popped him up. Harrison is there. And the inning is over. Bottom of the inning now, and next will be the imposing power bat, Matt Chapman. Here's the 1-1 delivery.
Ball.
Liner toward right center. And that's a base hit. 1-for-2 in his first couple of plate appearances.
Up next to Oakland, the designated hitter, Chris.
At the plate now, Chris Davis. And he lays off upstairs, but it's ruled a strike, and he can't believe it. 1-2. And he got him. One out, runner at first, and striding toward the plate to hit next, Tony Kemp.
Tony Kemp.
1-1 is taken for ball two. He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
Team's been struggling on offense. Let your D work for you right here. Pound the zone.
Full count,
now, 3-2.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
So he notched the backwards K on that one. Tony Kemp becomes out number two this inning. In comes Seth, coming home with the 1-1 pitch. Swing, and there it goes. Deep to left. No chance at bringing this one back. And out of here. And I mean by plenty. That ball was crushed. At the plate, Josh Harrison. And he fouls this one off. Softly on a line to third. And oh, that caroms right up on over his head and down the line.
The center fielder, number two.
Starling. Stepping in now, Starling Marte. That fastball's too much for him there. 1-2.
At the ball.
Two with a sinker that runs off the inside. Here now the 2-2. Now a swing, and he gets him to pop it up. And no one can get there. It's a foul ball. Here's another 2-2. Maybe trying to back him up a bit there with the fastball.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
Right on that pitch that time as he wraps it into center field, a base hit. So now they'll have runners on the corners with two away.
Now batting, first baseman.
Standing in now, Matt Olson. This is on the ground over the first. And that'll get on through into right field for a base hit. And the runner scores from third as they extend their lead.
The left fielder, number 20, Mark.
So now to the plate, Mark Hanna, fouled away. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes.
Now 2-2. This is the pitch where you want to attack the zone. If you go 3-2, then you put the runners in motion.
Looking to punch him out again. The pitch. Fly ball out toward right field. And no trouble for him as he makes the catch to end the inning. Set to lead us off in the sixth inning.
Offense needs to get going right here. You want to try and tighten up this game a little bit before it starts to get into that territory where you're going to start seeing the back end of each bullpen.
Two balls and a strike to count. Just does manage to get a piece there as this is bounced foul. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. And the sinking fastball called strike three, and that's out number one. So one away, and that will bring in the dangerous Cuban slugger, Jose Abreu. Here's strike two as it catches the outside corner. Hit in the air down the right field line. Long run for the right fielder. He can't get there in time, and now it hops over the wall for a ground rule double. James Kaprielian. right-handed reliever standing 6'3", gets the ball now out of the bullpen. Into the box now, Eloy Jimenez, fouled off. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Right fielder coming on. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out. So next to hit is Yoan Moncada, 1-for-2 in the ball game thus far. The 1-1 home.
Looked like he just tried to do too much with that fastball right there. He overthrew it a little bit. That's pretty much the case when you airmail a fastball like that.
Could have been 3-1. Instead, it's 2-2. And he comes back with a fastball. Strike three called, and the inning is over. Michael Kopech enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth.
Now pitching for Chicago, number 34.
Bottom of the sixth inning now. Digging in is the outfielder, Seth Brown. Swing and a drive to right. There it goes. Looking up is the right fielder. And goodbye. This one ain't coming back. Now, Matt Chapman.
Big fastball is definitely this guy's MO coming out of the bullpen.
And it's two balls and two strikes now.
Just missed with that heater, but even if he wanted to swing, I don't think he could have caught up to that one.
Four runs, seven hits, and no errors in the ballgame for the A's so far. And it's fouled away. And a fastball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight. Digging in next, Chris Davis, who went down on strikes in his last at bat. And this is taken for a called strike. Oh, that's a tough call. Now 1-2.
Great job on those last two. The varying speeds gave him a hard fastball, and then he locked him up with a changeup.
Two balls and two strikes, the count to Chris Davis. High in the air into shallow left center. Anderson is calling for it. Two down. Digging in will be Tony Kemp. He was punched out looking at strike three last time through.
Yeah, Matty, and hopefully he got it out of his system, especially now he's bear down. He gets the two strikes in this spot, has to put the ball in play.
Here's the 1-2 delivery.
Well, that's off the plate.
Hit fairly well out towards straightaway center. He's under it, and that ends the inning. And here's the switch hitting catcher, Yasmani Grandal. He went down on strikes last time up. Payoff pitch home. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. And he fouls this one off. The 3-2 one more time. He struck him out, the third time he's fanned in the game. So next to bat will be Gavin Sheets, grounded out in his last at bat. He loses him on ball four. And stepping in, Andrew Vaughn, a hit in two at-bats for him at this point in the ballgame. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Kenna is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first. The throw is wild, and it gets away. Next, it'll be Cesar Hernandez, struck out in his last trip to the plate. The 1-1. Sheets is off of first with two away. Hot shot down the line. But this will be a foul ball as that evens things at 2-2. Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way. Softly hit to short. Throw to second for the force out, and the side is retired. Jose Ruiz gets the call from the pen to take the ball for the home seventh.
Number 66.
Ready to take his hacks again. Sean Murphy blasted a two-run homer in his last at-bat.
That last at-bat, that showed me something. It's not that easy to hit a changeup over 400-plus feet out of the ballpark. So this guy gets some good extension, strong wrist, and this guy's got some terrific bat speed.
And the payoff pitch, chopper to short. No problem here, one away. Josh Harrison stands in. A hit in two tries for him so far. The 2-1 home. Swing and a line drive. And a leaping effort, but it's off his glove. And the throw is not going to be in time as he's able to reach base safely. In now, Starling Marte. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. And a breaking ball in the dirt that time for a ball.
No reason to sit on anything other than hard stuff in a location you like and drive it right now.
Swing and a liner. And that's into the outfield for a one-out hit. And they'll have runners at second and third following the one-out double.
Now batting, the first baseman,
and it looks as though the decision makers in the dugout will give him a free pass to first, so the bases are loaded here on the intentional walk, and the force play is now in order. Here now the 2-2. Fouled away. The 2-2 one more time.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
Swung on, but it's pulled foul wide of third. And he'll get to see another one. It'll be the 10th pitch of this at-bat. Try it again, 3-2. And that misses. Ball four. A run will come in to score. Ronaldo Lopez was called upon to pitch, really needing that double play ball. Bases are loaded here with only one man out. Seth Brown will be the first to meet him here, and they'll do so in an enviable situation indeed. Bases loaded and only one out now.
Yeah, Matt, and going back to that last at-bat when he hit the homer, that was a fastball that was up in the zone. This guy likes the ball up in the zone, so if I'm on the mound right now, I'm thinking try to keep the ball at the knees and below. He doesn't handle that low pitch quite as well.
Oh, and it misses ball four, and that will force home a run. swing and a ball lifted in the air toward the line and right. In there, a base hit. And the runner scores from third as they extend their lead. It's now 7-1.
Now back, the designated hitter. Chris.
Into the box, Chris Davis. Now a fastball awfully close, but he doesn't get the call. It's 2-2 now.
Everyone in the ballpark knows what the pitcher's intentions are in this situation. Great job at the plate to lay off a tough pitch in a good spot.
2-2. Hit the other way out toward right field. Long run for the right fielder. He gets there to make the catch, but this should bring home a run as the runner tags from third. And they'll extend their lead even further as the run from third is in to score. So two are gone now in the Oakland half of the seventh. And striding toward the plate to hit next, Tony Kemp. Breaking ball. That's in the dirt as he takes a ball.
He's got a couple of pitches to deal with right here, but he's starting to lose command of his pitches. It might be time to take a step back and try to refocus and making some good pitches.
Eatman count, two balls and two strikes. He's set. Here's the 2-2. Now a foul tip at the plate, and you can hear that one ring off the catcher's mask as he stays alive. And that misses there, so he runs the count full now.
Wow, these guys are really grinding out their at-bats in this one. They're not making any outs easy to get. And that, of course, is having a huge impact on the pitch count.
And he struck out again. That's the third time he's gone down on strikes in this one. Ready to begin the eighth. And up next, it'll be Tim Anderson. 3-1. Full count now, 3-2. He's ready for the payoff pitch. High in the air down the right field line. But this will wind up being a foul ball. Once again, a 3-2. Now a swing and a fly ball. But this is just going to wind up being a foul ball. Payoff pitch one more time. To first. He's right there. And he'll step on first for the out, three unassisted. Stepping up is Luis Rubber, who could really use a knock here. 0 for 3 in the game so far. And this is taken here for ball four. Just the second walk he's allowed into his eighth inning of work. Now at the plate, Jose Abreu. He's working on a 1-for-2 game so far. Ready with two balls and a strike. Robert stands at first with one out. Again, another foul ball.
You know, taking you inside the mind of a batter right here, you can't get in auto swing mode. You still have to control the strike zone.
And he misses this one inside, and that'll run things full, 3-2.
Hey, this has been an epic at-bat right here. I don't blame the pitcher for a little nibbling right there. Maybe get a swing and a miss. He didn't bite on that once, and now we go full count.
The 3-2 one more time. Oh, and this ball is absolutely blasted. High and deep. And that ball will stay fair, and it's gone. A home run. At the plate, Eloy Jimenez. And this is popped up near second base. Kemp takes charge, and he's got it. Two down. Next to bat will be the Cuban import, Yoan Moncada. It was a backwards K, a strikeout looking for him in his last at bat.
Yeah, pretty deflating at bat right there, Matty. Not only
a swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. Bottom of inning number 8 set to go, and that'll bring up Sean Murphy. A good pass at that ball, just a little late, and now the count's full. As we near the end of this one, it's clear the long ball has played a big role in today's outcome. And D-Row, what are your final thoughts on what we've seen?
Yeah, just non-competitive pitches in some big situations, Dan, and the offense took full advantage.
Yeah, you know, D-Row, one of the things about pitching is you want to have location, and it was obvious in this one today that the pitchers weren't on point, and what happens when that happens? Hitters make you pay, and the long ball was a big part of this one here.
At the plate now, Josh Harrison. And that's taken in straightaway right. Will he try from second? Next to stand in is Starling Marte. So far, 2 for 3 in this one.
Marte.
Nope. 2 balls and a strike.
You got 2 balls, 1 strike.
Swing and a liner. But this will wind up a foul ball. 2-2. Swing and a miss, and they'll dodge a bullet that time. 2 away.
Now batting.
That'll bring up the power hitter, Matt Olson. Matt. Runner in scoring position with Sugar. 1-1 is in off the plate.
Inside, ball two.
Runner in scoring position at second with 2 down. Let's see what they throw Olson on a 3-1 count.
3 balls.
Mark Hanna would be next if they can keep this inning alive. And he's taking here and looks at strike two right down the middle.
One of the most frustrating things for me to watch in this game is guys getting count leverage and not pull.
Threw it right past him. A miss at the gas, and that ends the inning. Here's Merrill Petit. Comes on from the pen, hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the ninth.
Number 36.
Here's the catcher, Yasmani Grandal. In previous matchups with Yasmeral Petit, he's a .333 hitter. He's also hit 3 home runs. 3 balls and a strike to the Chicago leadoff hitter.
Now this is a leadoff at bat. Great patience, and he's just waiting for that pitch that's too good to pass
up.
And this pitch misses here. It's ball four, and they've got a leadoff base runner aboard to start the ninth.
The designated hitter.
And now, Gavin Sheets. It was a walk in his last trip. On the ground to second base. This could be two. There's Harrison for one. Back to first. A ninth inning double play. And they're an out away from closing this one out. Next to hit is Andrew Vaughn. He comes to the plate as the last chance for his side. Two out here in the ninth. The 2-1 home, taking called strike two, and now they're down to their final strike tonight. The White Sox down to their last strike. Struck him out, and that'll do it tonight for the White Sox.
Hey, one of the keys to having a good record in baseball is to win some games at home, so this was a big win, winning home for their home crowd.
8-3 tonight. Oakland used a nice fifth inning to take the lead, and they never gave it back. Chris Bassett earns the victory on the mound. So that'll do it for us. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi White, our entire crew, I'm Matt Vaskirjan. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com.
Here now is our final line score tonight. First for the victorious Athletics, 8 runs on 11 hits. No errors, they left 8 men on base. For the White Sox, 3 runs, 5 hits, no errors, they left 5 men on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 24 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this evening. We remind you to please drive home.